Consecutive governments continued to bring in manifestos and promise to the people that constitutional changes would be brought in. Don't you think that is what the people want in that sense, because they voted in?
But if you look at the major promises that were given, were probably during the height of the war. So that's when there was a need for a political solution, especially to the North and East conflict, as well as empowering the provincial councils. But since then, you had to really look into the issues and see if there was any, there is any need to give more powers to the provincial councils or to take out more powers from the executive presidency. Personally, I feel executive presidency has worked in Sri Lanka very well, and if they are to give powers to the parliament, a powerful prime minister coming in, I really hope the powers within the parliament stay within the parliament rather than being given to the provincial councillors. I don't think even the president, the current president, wants to do a change on the executive presidency, even though it was promised. But if it does come into parliament, we will probably vote in for a system where the leader of the country gets a little bit more power, whether it's a presidency or it's a prime minister, the parliament. Because if you divide the powers between the president and the prime minister, it'll be the same scenario in the last 3 years, where the president takes a decision and where the prime minister overrules it, where the prime minister takes a decision, where the president overrules it. So that doesn't benefit the country.
Talking about the provincial council, powers to the provincial council matter, I think they still talk about the North and East, devolving power to the North and East, powers vested within that region of our country. As a young person, a politician, what have you got to say?
You have to look at the other provinces as well, the 8 other provinces. The same powers which are vested within the southern province is also vested within the northern province. But if you look at the workload that is being done in the 2 provinces, there's a big gap between the two. I feel the powers that are given to the province in the northern province is probably not being utilized. If you look at the allocated funds, if you look at the development that has been taking place, the same amount of money that has been given to the southern provincial council was given to the northern provincial council as well as the eastern provincial council. If you look at the end of each year from 2012, the money sent back to the central government from the northern province and the eastern province is way much more than the other 7 provinces.